Crosstalk, where all things are considered. I'm Peter LaBelle. To remind you, we're discussing some real news. And now we're joined by Alexander Mercuris in London. He is a writer on legal affairs as well as editor-in-chief of TheDurant.com. Alex, welcome to the program here. Well, we have the sequel. Russiagate lives on. I thought it was in traction, but no, it has new life. And it's the same figures in the swamp in the intel community that tells us it's alive and kicking. And then in the sequel, as you've well noticed, Bernie Sanders is playing a very important, if not leading, role. So in one way, Donald Trump and Bernie Sanders have to share the stage in equal terms. I have to say that I am aghast by this. I thought we'd been through it enough times, but it seems to be the only thing that keeps the political establishment and the media together on their war against Donald Trump when it's, what, 250-odd days out for a general election, presidential election. Go ahead, Alex. Go ahead.
Well, absolutely. I mean, what did they say? That, you know, history repeats itself. The first time is tragedy. The second time is farce. Now it's repeating itself as farce, followed by further farce, because this is completely farcical. We now have both Donald Trump, the leader of the right in the United States, and Bernie Sanders, the leader of the left in the United States, and Russia supposedly is helping and manipulating both. I mean, it's so crazy that, you know, one wonders, have people in the United States taken complete leave of their senses? I mean, it is on that level of total absurdity. And consider, we have the New York Times promoting the myth of Russian help for Donald Trump. We have the Washington Post promoting the myth of Russian help from Bernie Sanders. It's the two newspapers of record, the two big traditional newspapers, that are being drawn out to pull this sort of game. Now, you know, the other thing I have to say is, you know, never give up, apparently, on a failed strategy. It didn't work with Donald Trump. So what do? You try again. You actually expand it. And I'm hearing that Bernie Sanders is doing very well in Nevada.
Yes.
So it's obviously not working.
Yeah, okay.
You
well, that,
still carry on.
That's exactly where I wanted to go. I just wanted to also stress, Stephen, to our viewers, again, based on anonymous sources, okay?
Yes, yes, yes.
Of course, okay. But, Stephen, this is all happening for a reason. And I'll give you my scenario here. Mm-hmm. You had the conviction and sentencing of Roger Stone.
Yes.
For the pushers, people that support and back this conspiracy theory, this ridiculous hoax, they needed that conviction and
Absolutely.
Sentencing to make, legitimize.
At least one of them.
One of them. And then we have this week coming up, we have the extradition trial of Julian Assange being tied to, WikiLeaks being tied to Russia. And now we have this. And against Bernie Sanders. And the reason why they're doing it against Bernie Sanders, because he's winning.
Mm-hmm.
He's winning.
Yes,
he
exactly.
got more than 50% in Nevada. That is an astounding outcome. This is all connected together. That's why they're resurrecting it.
Well, there's only one thing that is more destructive than the hostility of the mainstream media in the United States. That is their love. They poured so much love on Joe Biden that now Joe Biden is losing despite his huge financial support and the media support. Why? They loved him so much, they kept talking that he had nothing to do with Burisma. And finally, tens of millions of Americans got to know the name of that Ukrainian company very well. And I think it basically destroyed Joe Biden's campaign.
You know,
but again, coming back to what you just said, well, I think that Sanders, you know, this campaign about his involvement with Russia is so absurd. Only he can destroy his chances. You know, when he said, "My message to Russia is stay out of American election." Well, my message to him is don't be a nincompoop, you know. Don't push the same theories that stole your chance to be nominated in 2016.
You know, Alex, you know, one of the things I find very interesting in looking at the coverage of this, these allegations from these anonymous sources, it seems to me they're like living in a time capsule. You know, Bernie Sanders visited Moscow on his honeymoon. Actually, I think it was he came during the Soviet Union. There was a sister city thing. I think it was Moscow and a city in Vermont. I mean, there was a reason for him to be here. He happened to be having his honeymoon here at the same time. But they're trying to stretch this out. Is it Russia? As if Russia is still a communist country? They're making this really weird connections, and that's something that is, you know, 30 years ago. But for the media, it's still the same narrative. And in their minds, because nothing has ever changed in the country I've lived in for 30 years, it must be the same. And the same Bernie, the same commie, is now getting support
from the Kremlin.
I mean, it shows any lack of depth of knowledge. Go ahead.
Well, there's absolutely no knowledge. I mean, this is one of the things that came across for me very clearly throughout Russiagate. And right at the very center of the US intelligence community world, there is a basic failure of knowledge about Russia. Yeah. And can I just say, Russia is in some ways the victim in all of this, because it has been constantly blamed by the US political establishment, the militant center, as I think somebody called it, of the United States, for whatever goes against the establishment. So if the left does well, that's Russia's fault. If the right does well, that's Russia's fault. And Russia is constantly used in this way in American partisan struggles. And the result is that Russia gets sanctioned, Russia gets criticized, its political leaders get demonized, and the whole prospect of improved relations between the United States and Russia, two extremely important countries, Russia, the world's other great nuclear superpower, that prospect gets indefinitely postponed. And Russian people, ordinary Russian people, are constantly caught in the crossfire. We saw that with Maria Butina. I mean, we've seen this again in Italy, where the Russian athletes were frisked just before they were due to involve themselves in an important race. There's no question at all, in my opinion, all these things are connected.
You know, Tima, again, these anonymous sources coming out of the intel community. Donald Trump was supposed to drain the swamp. He's being overwhelmed by the swamp to this day. I mean, this is, again, a continuation of the same strategy they had before the election, after the election, and it's just being badly being reinvented.
Well, I mean, if only Russia had been just a victim of all of this, I completely agree with Alexandra that basically it's absurd. I mean, let me just quote a Republican senator, Chris Stewart, defending Trump against the accusations that he is a Russian agent. I'd challenge anyone to give me a real world argument where Putin would rather have, why Putin would rather have President Trump and not Bernie Sanders, Mr. Stewart said in an interview, citing Trump's, you know, anti-tank weapons for Ukraine, you know, expelling Russian diplomats.
Ending arms control agreements.
Ending arms control. So this is making the world less and less safe. You know, if you want to be the president of the United States, you have to show hostility to Russia, the second next nuclear superpower. So it just destroys security on our planet. The American political life is destroying security. And not only American political life. I completely agree with Alexander that it's not just American nationalists or hawks. It's the militant center. You know, you just mentioned Julian Assange. You know, the European press, you know, kind of feels obliged to pay at least lip service to supporting Julian Assange. Der Spiegel, the liberal German magazine, what is their headline on Assange's trial? Trump's America is against WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange.
Not just
Trump's
Trump.
America. Was it Trump who made Assange stay in the Ecuadorian embassy in London? Was it Trump who imprisoned Bradley Manning and basically tortured him? No, it was the adorable liberal, you know, Mr. Obama. It was in the times when Hillary Clinton was the Secretary of State. But these people, the so-called liberals in Europe and in the United States, they want us to have blank spots in our memory. They want to destroy all the things, all the positive things connected to Russia, and they want to stress all the negative things. And they forget, you know, these German and French and British liberals, they forget that Russia was the only country that dared to give political asylum to Edward Snowden. None of them had the courage to do it.
It's not the first time liberals have amnesia here. Let me go back to Alexander. You know, one of the things I find really kind of comical, never been able to understand, is that why would the Kremlin have a preference either way? I mean, because it's just going to be more hostility. It doesn't make any difference. I find it just really comical that, you know, they're scheming about supporting this side against that side and maybe support both of them against each other. I mean, this is an assumption that has never been given any kind of serious thought. Go ahead, Alexander.
Well, that's right, because, of course, the Kremlin doesn't have a preference. It understands perfectly well that it is actually disastrous for Russia to interfere in American politics. That's why, one important reason, by the way, why I have always been extremely skeptical about the whole Russiagate conspiracy theory, which, after multiple investigations, has proved to be, well, you know, the evidence for it has been threadbare and bitterly contested. So why would the Russians try and manipulate the American electoral process when the only result has been that relations between the United States
just get worse
and Russia just get worse? So why would they do it? I'm sure they're not doing it. And I'm sure that all of this is purely a product of American partisan politics, which unfortunately have now resulted in a situation where if the establishment candidate loses, be it Joe Biden, be it Pete Buttigieg, be it Mike Bloomberg, it's always the fault of the Russians. It's never the American people exercising their own democratic...
Well, the problem is that the political elites in the United States abhor democracy and they have contempt for the voter. That's all the time we have. Many thanks to my guests here in Moscow and in London. And thanks to our viewers for watching us here at RT. See you next time. And remember, Crosstalk Rules.